Something I didn't mention before on your handouts, on the very front page of both your IS F and LX, there is an FTP site with a username and password that you can go on and get the presentation electronically if you want to get them that way. Okay, we've had the LX model since 1996, started out with an LX450, then went through LX470 in 99, and a couple of general minor changes from then till now, and now we have the third generation LX570. Coefficient of drag on this vehicle is 0.35, and it's one of the most powerful in its segment. We'll talk a little bit about the key selling points that Nancy just mentioned, but first of all, a list of new features. And again, you'll have these in print, so I'll try to just skim over them. First of all, we'll talk about the crawl control is first in class. The front wide view and side monitor is Lexus first and first in class. Power sliding, the auto function on power windows, the power seats with memory in these vehicles. Body and styling incorporates the Elfin-S styling direction that we've added on some of our sedans. And with that, we added headlamp washers, integrated headlamp housing with the fenders so it fits more in with the style, UV reduction glass with laminated windshield and front door glass. The side view of this gives you a little bit of look with the roof rack, and that is now a standard with crossbar. And we have larger 20-inch wheels, standard roof rack, chrome-accented door handles and side molding, and body-colored rear spoiler. From the rear, we have LED tail lamps and brake lamps with chrome accents around the license plate and the tow hitch cover on the lower part of the bumper. Dimensions. Overall width, 77.6 inches. We gained 1.2 inches in length, or width rather. The height, 75.6 with a standard roof rack. And the track, we added 1 inch to the front and back to 64.6 and 64.4. For other dimensions, the overall length, we gained 3.94 inches, but the wheelbase stayed the same at 112.2. Weight distribution, 51 front, 49 rear. We had breakover, key off-road features. The approach angle on this vehicle is very good. Normal height, you know, we have the hydraulic suspension, so we can have it in high mode or in normal, but in the normal mode, it's 29 degrees. In the high mode, it's 31 degrees. Breakover angle, once we raise it up a little bit, normal height's 23, high height is 27. Departure angle is 20 under normal and 23 under high. Normal running ground clearance is 8.9 inches. The lighting on the vehicle, low beams are projector type halogen low beams. High beams are multi-reflector halogen. And we have added the AFS or adaptive front lighting system where both lights swivel into the turns and it's all speed related. System can be shut off as with our other vehicles with just a button on the dash. Rear lighting is the tail and brake lights are LEDs along with the high mount brake light. The wheels are 20-inch 10-spoke aluminum alloy, full-sized alloy spare included. We keep that going with this vehicle. The tires are P285 50R20s, 111V mud and snow. It also has the new tire pressure monitor system, and these are the direct type pressure sensors for the vehicle. Let me back up to that one. We also have an instrument panel. It's able to tell you the amount of pressure in each wheel or each tire as you pull it up, including the spare. The new engine in this vehicle is shared with the Tundra full-size pickup and the Land Cruiser. Compression ratio is 10.2 to 1. Horsepower 383 at 5,600. Maximum torque 403 foot-pounds at 3,600. We added an oil cooler to this system because we added the trailer towing package up to 8,500 pounds. 0 to 60 mile per hour, 7.2 seconds. Top track speeds, 137 miles an hour. Quarter mile is 15.8. The TMC estimated fuel economy is 12 city and 18 highway. Fuel tank capacity, 24.6 gallons, and the emissions rating is California ULEV 2. For the VVTi, we didn't add the electronic control for the intake cam, so we have hydraulic control for both cams and still able to take care of that with 60-degree adjustable phase for both cam timings. The advanced valve train, this one doesn't have the direct injection, but it does have the normal configuration of port injection, just different intake and exhaust ports to help it with the horsepower. Transmission-wise, we have an all-new 6-speed automatic that is lighter in weight than we've had before. We use a low friction design in some of the clutch discs. They help take care of some of that. And we have this, the ratios in 6 speeds. Notice the first gear is a 3.33, so I got a real low first gear. And I've got 2 overdrives to give us a little bit better fuel economy on the road. It also has second gear start if you're going to be in a snowy or icy condition or a muddy condition where you need to take off some of that pressure on takeoff. The transfer case, this is a full-time four-wheel drive unit. It is has electric locking center diff as well as a torsion center diff. It's real similar to what we've had on the GX470 model for the torsion center. For the transfer case shift lever, you notice in the center console now we have 4 buttons down in the center right behind the shifter. And the very left-hand side you see H4 and L4. So this is how you're actually going to shift it between the two. On the dash, you see the lower right of your picture, there is the button on the dash on the right side of your wheel. You push that if you want to lock it. You do have the limited slip in there, so it's going to lock it most of the time for you, but if you need to, you can lock it up directly. Again, if you're towing with this vehicle, it'll tow up to 8,500 pounds, has a Class 4 hitch, and it's underneath the cover, and the 7-pin connector is under the right side of the bumper. Off-road capability, 45-degree maximum climb angle, 43-degree maximum side slope angle, water fording maximum of 27.5 inches. Outfitted with skid plates, engine transfer case fuel tank with skid plates, and has front tow hooks. Suspension-wise on this vehicle, we have coil over with double A-arm. Previous was a torsion bar, if you remember, on the 470, and the long stroke design has been increased from 7.87 to 9.05 inches, or a gain of 30 millimeters. Maximum wheel articulation is 24.8 inches. Rear suspension, 4-link coil spring suspension with lateral control rod type, and provides excellent travel and articulation without sacrificing a lot of ride comfort. For 4-wheel active height control, this also still has the hydraulic suspension, but it's a whole different configuration. It's kind of an X pattern. And when you get your spec sheet, it will go through a whole scenario of how it works with pictures and diagrams. So I'm not going to cover that part here. You also are able to turn that off with a button in front of the button on the console. You have the height select switch for high, normal, or low, and AVS dampening mode switch of sport, normal, or comfort. There is 6 different settings for the height control. You're able to adjust 3 of them, and the other 3 are controlled depending on where you put the, like say, if you put it in crawl mode, it's going to go to a higher position already for you. If you wanted to use the ingress egress button that we have here on this part of the dash, on the left side you turn it on, a little button there, you'll see it come up in the dash in the green diagram. If you have it in this mode and you're driving in normal condition, pull up to a stop sign or get ready to shut it off, hit the start stop button, but don't open the doors yet, and it will drop for you real quick. That's just an easy way of getting in and out of the vehicle. Variable gear ratio steering. We still have the variable gear ratio on this vehicle, and it is engine speed sensing instead of vehicle speed sensing. Brakes. Front brakes are 13.39 inches. Ventilated disc rotors, 4 piston calipers. Rear brakes are 13.59 inches, and again, ventilated disc with single piston calipers. We have standard safety features like ABS, BA, HAC, EBD, a lot of acronyms, ATRAC, and VSC. Multi-terrain ABS has been, we've changed ABS a little bit on this vehicle, so it's able to understand. When you're off-road to this and you start getting a wheel slip, the wheel speed sensors are able to calculate which ones are slipping, what kind of terrain you're on, and give you better braking ability when you do go off-road with it. So you'll notice that when you go out and drive it on the off-road course we've got for you today. First-in-class crawl control. Some of you may have been on the Land Cruiser route with this and been able to test it, but we do have it, and just a couple of things to give you on this as you go out and drive it, because that's why we got the off-road course for you, is first of all, you have to put it in low range. To be able to get in crawl control, it has to be in low. So we put the shift lever in neutral, and push the button and pull it back into L4, and it will shift for you. Once you do that, turn the on button for crawl mode. And then the next one is the 1, 2, or 3.5 mile per hour that you can go with this. It'll go forward, backward, uphill, downhill. There's a couple of precautions, though. If you touch the brake or touch the accelerator, it thinks you want control back, and it gives it back to you, okay? If you step on the brake, though, if you let off of it, it'll take about a half a second to a second. It will come back on, but like we've got a hill, just kind of go up and then down. So most of the time you cross over the top of a hill, what do you want to do? Step on a brake, right, till you see what's on the other side. But if you'll trust me with this one, it's okay to go down the other side. Just let it do its thing, and it'll go down for you. But if you do step on the brake, then let off, it may get to halfway to the bottom of the hill before it comes back on. On acceleration, if you accelerate over 6 miles per hour on this, it will actually take away the accelerator function. In other words, I can't go uphill, it won't accelerate uphill for you. You have to stop and reset. Okay? Just some FYIs on using the crawl mode. First in class crawl control, this is kind of a video of turning on the switch and moving the button. We filmed this out in Death Valley, California, so you're able to see some of the scenery out there as well as watch this vehicle go up and over some of the humps. It actually will crawl very well over some very rough terrain. Matter of fact, in Japan, we got a video showing where they was crawling over boulders about 3 to 4 foot diameter and just going up an old creek bed. And if you let it do its thing, it will crawl over it. Matter of fact, they actually took the vehicle out and sunk it in sand in low four-wheel drive and buried it. It would not pull itself out. Put it in crawl mode and turned it loose, and it walked itself out of the condition it was in. So it's something to try. Matter of fact, we may want to try that one of these days. Take the running boards off and go bury it and do a little playing with it. Anyway, moving right along. Wide view front and side monitor. This vehicle on the top left, it's kind of confusing to look at the picture. The top left of the screen, I'll see if this pointer will kind of work. You see a couple of buttons, a 3 and a 2. This is the first buttons on our car that if you are in, like this one's in the 3 mode, but it's not lit, okay? Why it's that way, we asked for them to change it, so we hopefully do by production. So when I touch the button up here, right now it's in the 3 mode, and all the 3 mode means if I'm going to back up. If we push this button that's on the dash to the right side of the wheel, then it will have 3 modes. I'll have just the front view, just the side view, or a combination of all three. I'll have all 3 of those modes. If I push this button up here again and the 2 goes dark, then if I push this button on the dash, come back here. If I push this button on the dash, then I go from the front side view to the nav screen. That's the 2 different ways you can manipulate this. As well as here you have an auto button. If that light is lit, every time I get below 5 miles per hour, these cameras come on. So that way if you're going rock crawling or you're going to go out in a crawl mode, you want to see what's directly in front of your bumper and to the side of your vehicle, you can leave it on and watch it through the cameras. The camera position on this side, you notice under the L, you'll notice a little black bubble just under the L. That would be the front camera, and the right mirror does have a bubble underneath it as well for the 2 cameras. You get a chance to play with that today. First in class pre-collision system. We still have the radar cruise we've had in the past, but we also add the pre-collision on this. So we still get it prepares the brake to BA and then tightens up your seatbelt in case of an accident. Best in class 10 airbags, roll sensing curtain airbag. And when you go out to the track today, they're going to ask you to turn that off. Again, we have the RSCA button off switch. Just make sure you push that. 3-point seat belts with all 8 seating positions, front and second row seat belt pretensioners. Active headrest. This is a Lexus First, standard on the front seats. What happens is in an accident, you get rear-ended, your body goes back into the seat, and it's cable-driven, so it pushes the headrest up and behind your head by way of a cable, so it's all mechanical. Smart access. We've added this to most all of our vehicles, including this one, but we did add the remote engine start, like some of the Toyota models have already. Instrument panel. Optotron display. With the gauges, notice this is how it looks with just normal daytime cruising. And when I turn the lights on at night, it gives a real blue halo and gives you a little different look at it. Seating position, 8-person seating, best in class front leg room, and versatile and lots of cargo area in the back. Remember, the second row seats has a power slide. The seat bottom is a 60-40 split. The seat backs is a 40-40-20, so I can have a fold-down armrest in between the two seats. The two rear seats, third row seats, are power fold-up and power fold-down, and a manual lift up the back part of the seat. You can see that outside when you actually go out to the vehicle. All-new power rear door. The upper portion is power similar to the RX model. There's a button on the dash or on the key fob you can just push and hold, and we'll raise it for you and we'll close it for you. As well as up underneath the tailgate area, there's the button that you can push like the RX has. The bottom part of the tailgate is a manual. You just push the pull the lever and it will come down gas operated. Then when you go back and put it to the first click, then it has the door closer, so it's able to close it for you. Make sure it is closed. And then for four-zone climate control, this is a best-in-class climate control. All four, or the first and second row, four seating position can change their own temperatures. Has 28 outlets. We added 10 more outlets in this vehicle, so it gets plenty of chance to keep everybody cool or warm. A subcool accelerator system, you've probably seen this in some of the other models, where we have high-pressure hot liquid, low-pressure cool liquid, that kind of goes through the same tube and helps cool down the hot liquid for better performing air conditioner system in the back. Luxurious interiors. Think about all the stuff that we have in this. We have the controls on the steering wheel, audio on the left side, phone navigation, multi-information display, and cruise control, chrome accents around the nav screen, adjustable armrests, and these just slide forward and backward on both sides for the front. For leather trim, we have 4-spoke wood and leather trim steering wheel. Shift lever is leather and wood trimmed. We have a medium brown California walnut and semi-aniline leather, gray and ivory. For colors, we have twilight gray metallic, starfire pearl, mercury metallic, golden almond, noble spinel, and black onyx. You will see a blue LX out there today. If you're taking photos, don't take a picture of that one because that color doesn't come out with this vehicle at launch, okay? Electronics in this vehicle is quite a number. We have the navigation system that is the 5th generation satellite-based nav system. It has the hard drive Mark Levinson system, real similar in most every aspect as the LS460 or 600HL with XM nav traffic, home link, and the backup camera. And with that, I think that's all I have for you. I'll turn